Trying to get Grimson into a scrap here. And
Matthew Barnaby hasn't got a lot of ice time this year, Bob. And he's kind of upset. So when he does get out there, he tries to get himself noticed. And that's the way Barnaby will do that. He wasn't choosy right there going after Stu Grimson. And certainly Stu doesn't back off. Barnaby. And Matthew Barnaby will remain on the ice. Jágr comes on. Oh, the referee sent the change back to the bench. It was a little too late. So Grimson backs off. When you're trailing in the game like Barnaby, you're trying to get things straight up. Oh, here they go.
As soon as they drop the puck, they drop their sticks and gloves, and we'll see what happens here.
And Barnaby's a game fighter, certainly, Bob. He gives up a lot of height, a lot of weight, and a lot of reach against Stu Grimson. And Stu trying to get a clear shot in. Now the helmet comes off.
Well, Stu Grimson has got the upper hand in this right from the start.
Bob, you mentioned they waited till the puck was dropped. They have to do that from the sense, otherwise you can get an automatic 10-minute misconduct, even a game misconduct, if it becomes too obvious. Well, Stu has the right arm open right now. He's trying to move it back and forth.
A jab there by...
Now it's back and forth. Man. Stu was changing hands. So again, Bob, you credit Barnaby from the standpoint of getting something going. Initially, Bob, I think a lot of credit has to go to Stu Grimson for not taking a penalty when you have a lead in the game. He backed off. Then when the faceoff came outside, it was kind of obvious. They both dropped their gloves, squared off. Barnaby and Grimson will go right to the dressing room. We'll have to wait to see what comes as far as the penalties. Maybe a little more than the obvious 5 minutes each fighting.
Well, the fans cheering Barnaby, but he got the worst of that deal.